While less than 2% of the human genome actually counts as coding for anything, there are more than 20,000 genes in just that 2%. Now, we refer to this major division in the genome as protein-coding DNA and non-coding DNA. Now, the rest of this lesson will actually continue to cover how this 2% of our genome still codes for all those proteins. The next lesson will actually start to reveal some more about the role of this 98% of non-coding DNA. To make sure that your understanding of non-coding and protein-coding DNA sequences is clear, I've listed 5 different types of sequence that we could find in a genome. We have exons, introns, promoter regions, translated sequence between start and stop codons, and untranslated sequence that would be transcribed but outside start and stop codons. I want you to indicate which sequences in this list here, which sequences of DNA would be considered either coding or non-coding. So we're going to use the number 1 to represent coding and 2 to represent non-coding. So in each box, I want you to put either the number 1 or the number 2 to indicate whether an exon would be considered part of coding or non-coding sequence. Go ahead and pick which answer you think is best for each item in the list.